Welcome one, welcome all to Kareldia Imperial Age for Warband. This is another mod I downloaded and I'm gonna give it a go. See how it's played. I hope you enjoy. So we're starting a new game. And as you can see, you've got plenty of black powder age units on the back. And there we go. This is the start comments. And we'll continue to be a male. And we've got different things here, as an impoverished aristocrat, independently successful travelling merchant trader, veteran soldier in town militia, forest huntsman, nomadic horseman, and a petty thief. All in all, it's pretty common, but with just a bit of a twist here. So, as I don't know what this mod will do, so I'll get again the veteran soldier or rural forest huntsman. I'll go for the huntsman this time. And we've got a military cadet, academy cadet, an industrial engineer assistant, male carriage courier, and a petty gutter snipe, unregistered Kessick rider. I'll go for the military academy. And we've got mercenary in foreign lands, junior officer, petty violinist, university student, goods peddler, gunsmith engineer, independent Jaeger. Now, I think I'll go for this one. And of course, personal revenge. And we shall become an adventurer, ride into the new world. And we will allow me to quit without saving. So, as you can see, not that good of a stats in my point of view, because I love to have plenty of intelligence. I'll get one more strength, and as it is now, one agility. Okay. I'm pondering, and we've got different things here. So you've got marksmanship, we've got two, we've got fencing as well. Looting training. It's pretty much the same thing, but with this twist of marksmanship and fencing. More stylish, so we'll go for guns, and sporting, two on pathfinding as well. Don't know if we're gonna get too many prisoners out of this, since it's guns and all. So, what we will do is get one looting, wound and surgery. And again, we got plenty of archery and firearms. So we'll just deposit the rest on one-handed weapons, because I think that's what we'll most likely find here. And we are calling ourselves Lord. Lord what? Lord Hams. Yeah, sure, why not? And we're done. So we'll randomize a bit and... really odd ones. Nope. Oh well. Yeah, we'll keep it like it is. And let's see how it goes. We can go to Sweden, Vejer, Kyrgyz, Nordland, Rodok, and Saranit. And since I have no clue what's going to happen, I think we're going to go to Rodok's. Perhaps. And this is the same beginning as the other time, and look at that. We've got musket, but if we got a musket, a dagger, and a musket, and he missed, and we... Oh my. Something tells me I'm not gonna go for her. And, yep. Completely out of context I am. And we've got Ferri Nichiralle. Let's continue and talk to him. And they took his brother. Okay, interested I am. So let us see what we're gonna get through here. And deserters as soon as we put our feet out. So let's go back. And apparently plenty of deserters in this mod. Already two parties near me. And I'm still haven't done a thing. Captain Wilhelm von Huxkall. Not a salute. I, Captain Wilhelm von Uxkall of the Vejer Gregonir Regiment, would be damn offended if I do not least get one salute. For an officer or not, I demand you have a decency to give me a salute or buy me this bottle of Swedish wine at once.
My apologies there, Captain. I wish no offence to an elite member of Imperial Tsardom Army. I will, of course, buy this wine for you. Do not only avoid offence, pray tell me, though, what are you doing here so far from your own good regiment?
Then I wish to take back my remarks from this wine alone. As for my business here in this town, instead of serving with my fellow Vejer Grenadiers, back home I shall tell you. As you know, Grenadiers and Foot Guard are the elite forces of most modern armies, held back in reserve until that vital moment when we are needed to break the enemy in two. However, much to my superiors as well as my own disgust, the Vejer serves these days some of which are not fit enough to even cut a loaf of fine black bread.
Well, long tests.
You see, you need strong, tall men to serve as grenadiers, and men of good breeding and refinement willing to serve as officers too. But finding such men alone is quite difficult in the interior of my motherland, and there is high competition between us and the other elite of the Tsarina, and we do not wish to get the common chaff of our nation. So, I and several other officers have been given official orders and state backing to find and persuade strong and stout men to sign up for 15 years and serve with our glorious motherland now. Unfortunately, I have only come across cowards and weaklings, and I fear the assigned officer here in Jalkala is running out of patience with me, trying to poach what little he can force into his nation's army now. But interestingly, this is where you come in. I see now by your bearing and uniform you are a noble patriot of our own country, yes? No doubt your soldiers are conscripts pulled from depots or volunteers from the villages around this town, and compared to the trained soldiers of a modern army and our weak in courage and discipline, I am willing to march with you and your soldiers on the road to train them to highest standard or grandeur officer can bring you. In return, I will be happy to take a selection of the ones that I consider strong enough to devise your motherland when your campaign is over now. A grenadier officer as an aide-de-camp for myself and instructor for my men? I cannot deny such a prospect. It intrigues me now. You will willing to get your hands dirty and fight in the line like the rest of us?
Excellent, excellent. I've made a wise decision, choice now. And your answer, your questions, the thrill and the chaos of the fight is my bread and water. You not find me shrieking in duties when it comes to getting bloody, whether sword, pistol or musket. I am a strillable, able fencer with most one-handed blades, but do not forget I am grenadier officer, and the reason I am with you in the first place. I shall warn you that I do not care to fight for an officer of a nation or regiment who is lax in discipline with his men. For in the long run, they will not respect a soft hand, and good flogging or cutting of pay sharpens their memories and attitudes to a better standard.
That is understood. My men are not sloppy, because I've got none, and provincial militia now. And there should be no problems for them to adapt to the Vajir way you're doing things. A toast to Tsarina.
You need 400 denarii. Ah, yeah. All this talk, all this time, and marvellous. Swiss lion fentry. We'll just wait here for some time till these guys get away, and we leave to Bouvran. Recruit. We got one. Somehow. Don't think this will bode well for me. We've got here an army coming out. And recruit. 13. Marvellous. So that'll give me more than enough people. But money-wise is not that good. We've got Model 9 musket, 40 accuracy. Not that good, is it? We've got first to sell, that'll give us a bit of money. What we've got there, thieves. Can we get them? Everybody stand over there. And yes, we cannot use our musket on our horse. So it does not look all that good. I've got all of me. They must be coming out of that hill over there. So let's position our forces over here. There they come. My command, and fire. Go on, use. There we go. Very close quarter fighting. Can see bullets going everywhere. And with this, there's nothing I can do. Not with this tiny little dagger. And we're gonna try in. Oh, there you go. I did cut his throat with our dagger, but a bit odd in my point of view. Got sturdy boots we can get. Dagger, no. Boots, no. 5-5, no. And shall we put a hat on our head? Nah. Not that much. And let us get. We got upgraded people already. So I got. What a quartermaster is. Okay, we'll keep that, and got two National Guards. And let's go to Jalkala, see our friend Ferini Cirale. And okay, let's go get marketplace, arms, sell the dagger, 5 dinars. Could really use something like that. And armor, we've got these to sell, 17 dinars. Oh well, at least we've got a good price for the furs. And as always, there they are. There we go, and we will charge the enemy. We'll keep a higher ground here, fire at my will. And we'll take our chances and give in a bit of a shot. Yeah. Interesting enough. And getting ready to fire and all that. But the accuracy of this one, blimey. It's really, really bad. Didn't it? Oh well. It's going everywhere. See if I can give it a shot. Can I kill some of this? Don't think so. Look at that, all these men firing bullets and not one is hitting them. Oh my. He hit one of us. These guys have nice uniforms. Go, we've got lousy suits, and there we go, kidnappers hide out. And we've got two more National Guards. 12 thieves attacked the hideout and... Where are they going? Can't you tell me where they're going? Oh, they want the high ground. Fair enough. But do they see anybody? You need to be really close to get a hit on these guys. Just hope I'm not getting... Yeah, I can't recharge while running. So, you need to wait until you got this one done. And... Fire. And I still missed. So, as I said, not that good on accuracy, but I believe that's how things must have felt, because ever so close and I still miss. My best choice is getting a sword and getting them. And that hit his leg. I still killed him. Wow. These were powerful bullets. And can one... Oh my. We got more. Yeah. Knew it. And you... The National Guard just died. It was just a recruit, wouldn't bother me too much. And see, very, very close. And there we go. That must be the brother. Yay, yay. Let's continue and access. Got 200. Damage. It's a whole lot better than 120 because the stats are just the same as the other one. So we've got cartridges, we'll move the dagger down here, get more cartridges. Sturdy dry can. Ah, why not? Black gaiters. Nope. So this seems to be all over the place, price-wise. So there's no point of us going all the way up, coming out down, because maybe we can have more valuable things down here. Leave items on the floor. Let's return to Jilcala.